Now, when moving to lines in 3D, we're going to find that a parametric representation is more efficient. That's very different than what you're probably used to, so let's go over this with some care. What we're going to do is use some parameter, some dummy variable, and then tell you the x, y, and z coordinates as a function of that. So for example, let's say my parameter is r, and I tell you that x of r is 3r minus 5, that y of r is r plus 3, and that z of r is negative 4r plus 1. So as r goes from negative infinity to positive infinity, these x, y, and z coordinates trace out a line in three-dimensional space. So r is something like time. Now notice that the specifics of the parameter don't really matter. I could use a different variable. I could use s. I could say x of s is 3s minus 8, y of s is s plus 2, z of s equals negative 4s plus 5. This also gives me a line in three-dimensional space because each of these is some first-order function of the parameter. But even that is not strictly necessary. Let's say x of t is 3t cubed minus 5, and y of t is t cubed plus 3, and z of t is negative 4t cubed plus 1. Then even though this is not a linear function of the parameter, it's still tracing out a line, and in fact, all three of these parametrizations are tracing out the exact same line, a line passing through a point, negative 5, 3, 1, with the same direction given by these coefficients in front of the parameter terms, 3, 1, negative 4. Now, you can really see this if you think about what happens when you plug in r equals 0. You get that point, negative 5, 3, 1. And if I substitute s equals r plus 1, I get the second parametrization, as you can check with a little algebra. And lastly, if I substitute in t cubed equals r, I can see that the first and the third parametrizations are really giving me the exact same line. So that's what a parametrization of a line in 3D looks like. It takes a little bit of practice getting used to, but you can do it. Now, let's get some of that practice. Let's say I ask you for a line passing through the points 4, 2, 5, and negative 1, 3, 3. Okay, I'm going to choose, let's say, the first one as a base point. And then, to figure out the directions, I'm going to look at the changes in the x, y, and z coordinates as I move from one point to another. So I'm going to say x of t is the change in x, negative 1 minus 4 times t, plus the initial x-coordinate, 4. That simplifies to negative 5t plus 4. The same for y. Y of t is the change in y, 3 minus 2, times t, plus the initial y-coordinate, 2. That simplifies to t plus 2. And lastly, the same thing with z of t, simplifying to negative 2t plus 5. This, together, gives me a parametrization of a line. Check and make sure that when t equals 0, you get the first point, 4, 2, 5. What's the t value that gives you the second point? Negative 1, 3, 3. All right, here's another one. Let's say I want a parametrized line orthogonal to the plane given by 2x minus y plus 3z equals 9 at the point 4, 2, 1. Now we've got our base point, and what's going to matter about that plane is the coefficients, 2, negative 1, 3, out in front. Those slopes are telling you something about the direction orthogonal to that plane. So we're going to use those as the coefficients in front of the t terms. So x of t is 2 times t plus 4, where that 4 is the x-coordinate of the base point. Doing the same for y, we get y of t is negative t plus 2, and z of t equals 3t plus 1. Now, why this is orthogonal to the plane is something that's going to make sense a little bit later. For now, just think of this as practice with parametrizing that line. Okay, so much for 3D. The interesting linear objects are lines and planes. But what happens when we move to higher dimensions. What about 4 dimensions or 5 dimensions or even higher? Well, the big idea is that lines and planes in 3D are just the beginning of subspaces and hyperplanes in higher dimensions. Now, what's that? Hyperplanes? What is that? Physics. No. Look, don't get stressed out about it. We're going to slowly develop these ideas so that we can work comfortably in higher dimensions.